So now, how do we use that? Well, there are multiple ways to use that. One way, I told you, you have .NET Core, okay? .NET Core allows you to build ASP.NET applications. So for example, I have some people who use MVVM Light in ASP.NET project, and why not? It was not really made for that, but you can, why not? Like for example, the IOC container. Another way is in Xamarin, when you do a Xamarin Forms project, you can choose a sharing strategy, and for example, one of the strategies is .NET standard. So now I have MVVM Light that you can just reference into that and then use it. That's cool. But let's do another example. I'm going to go here and I'm going to create a new project. And now this time I'm going to take .NET Core. So I'm going to make an application, okay? And you see in .NET Core, I can select ASP.NET Core, so I can go on the web. And then after that, the cool thing with that is that you can deploy to Linux. So you can have a Linux web server run it. For example, on Azure, we have Linux web servers. You can deploy to that if you want, because sometimes it's cheaper, or sometimes it's, you know, your maybe your DevOps people, your IT pro people only know Linux, so they can use that. That's cool. In our case, we are going to do here a console application. So I'm just going to make a command line application. And let's call that core with MVVM Light. Okay, and I'm going to start implement this command line application. So let's imagine that it's a utility that I'm building, okay? And then I'm going to run that in command line. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'd like to add here a definition. So let's call that model. Then inside here, I'm going to add a new item. I'm going to take an interface and I'm going to call that iDataService. And here I'm going to specify what this interface does, and it's going to get the result. So imagine again that it's a utility class. In that case, I'm going to do something super simple. I'm going to take two numbers and then I'm going to call a service somewhere which is going to return the addition of those two. Oops. Imagine that this utility is doing something meaningful in the cloud or in a web service or whatever. In that case, it doesn't, but it's just for the demo. So I'm going to create an implementation of that. Let's add a new item. I'm going to take a class and I'm going to call that data service. And so let's do an implementation of that data service. Okay, I implement iDataService, voila. And this get result, we are going to do a real example where we are using an HTTP client. So I'm going to connect to the web. Okay, and in fact, I'm going to go into this URL. So what is this URL? It is an Azure function which I developed. What is an Azure function? Very quickly, in my session at 1:45, I'm going a lot deeper in Azure function, so come and check it out if you're interested. But basically, it is code running in the cloud in what we call a serverless manner. Actually, there is a server. It is on Azure, but basically, I don't have to manage this Azure server. So I'm just going to go here, and this is the code. You see that the code, or you will see in a second that the code is directly in the web browser here. And I have a URL for that. So it's like an API if you want. So I'm going to take this URL. Let's go back into my utility class. I'm going to add private const string URL equals and paste this URL. And so what my service is going to do, it's going to go here, get the result of this URL where I have the first number to string and the second number to string as well. And then it returns that. Now that's pretty cool, but here I'm hitting the web, okay? So what happens if suddenly I'm offline? Or what happens if I want to do some tests, some unit tests or something, and I'm completely offline now? Probably I should implement a test version of that service which doesn't go online, okay? So to do that, let's go here in the model again, add a class, and I'm going to call that test data service. And now this is also going to implement iDataService. But this time, what it's going to do, it's going to fake it. It's going to say, hey, I don't know how to count. I'm just a test program. And then it's going to return that, okay? Just a dummy implementation if you want.